Budget 2021 highlights. Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman presented her first paperless union budget today morning, February 1, 2021. This was Sitharaman's third budget under the National Democratic Alliance, NDA, government led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. In a significant departure from the tradition, this year's budget was only made available in a digital format. This budget leaves direct taxes unchanged. There is no any change in the tax slabs for salaried individuals, or the budget did not propose any changes in personal income tax slabs. This union budget 2021-22 incentivizes one person company. Government will now allow one person companies. NRIs allowed to operate one person companies or OPCs in India. Government has also eased requirements of residency for a person setting up a one-person company from 182 days to 128 days in India. The government proposes extension of tax holiday for start UPS by one more year. The government has announced highway works in various states, including 3,500 kilometers corridor in Tamil Nadu at 1.03 rupees lakh crores, 1,100 kilometers in Kerala at investment of 65,000 rupees crore, 675 kilometers in West Bengal at a cost of 25,000 rupees crore, and 1,300 kilometers in Assam at 19,000 crores in the next 3 years. These are the four pole-bound states. Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Assam, and West Bengal will see significant spending on highway road expansion. Overall, the FM proposes a total of 118,101 rupees lakh crore for Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. In financial year 2022 outlay, budget estimate for health and well-being is up 138% and is at 223,846 rupees crore. Government has also allocated 35,400 rupees crore towards COVID vaccines development for financial year 2022 and is committed to provide more if required. Urban Swachh Bharat Mission 2.0 announced with an outlay of 141,678 Indian rupees crore over 5 years from 2021. This focus on complete fecal sludge management, wastewater treatment, source segregation, management of waste from urban construction, and bioremediation of legacy dump sites. Government grants 1,000 rupees crores to the Solar Energy Corporation of India for the growth of the solar energy sector. Customs duty on solar lanterns cut to 5%. Indian Railways will have a national rail plan for up to 2030. Financial year 2022 allocation for railways are at 110,055 rupees crores. The next lot of airports will be privatized in Tier 2 and 3 towns and cities. The government gives tax holiday for aircraft leasing business in Gift City. BPCL, Concor, Pawan Hans, Air India divestments to be completed in financial year 2022. Divestment target for financial year 2022 at 1.75 rupees lakh crores. Pipelines of GAIL, India, LTD, Indian Oil Corp, IOC, and HPCL will be monetized. To support and facilitate economic growth, the government is introducing Atmanirbhar Swastha Bharat Yojana with an outlay of 64,180 rupees crore. Jal Jeevan Mission Urban will be launched with an outlay of 2.87 Indian rupees lakh crore over 5 years. This is aimed at universal water supply in all 4,378 urban local bodies, with 2.86 crore household tap connections and liquid waste management in 500 Amrit cities. Increase in FDI limit in insurance sector to 74% from the existing 49%. Government has allowed foreign ownership in insurance with safeguards. The government will also launch a Securities Market Code, which will include SEBI Act, Government Secretary Act, Depositories Act. SEBI will be notified as regulator for a gold exchange. The government is proposing to strategically divest two public sector banks and one general insurance company. In 2021-22, the government would also bring the initial public offer IPO of LLP, for which it will be bringing the requisite amendments very soon. The NCLT system will be strengthened, e-courts will be adopted, and alternate mechanism of debt resolution will be set up. The government has announced decriminalization of LLP Act. In May 2020, government announced the Atmanirbhar Bharat package to sustain the recovery further, also rolled out two more Atmanirbhar packages. Total financial impact of all packages including measures taken by RBI was estimated to be about 27.1 rupees lakh crores. Procurement from farmers has continued to increase at a steady pace. In case of wheat, total payment paid to farmers in 2013-14 was Rs 33,874 rupees crores. In 2019-20 it was 62,802 rupees crores. In 2020-21, it was 75,060 rupees crores. The total amount paid to wheat farmers was doubled in 2019-20 when compared to 2013-14. Agricultural credit will be increased to 16.5 lakh crore. Proposed to enhance the scope of the Operation Green Scheme to include 22 perishable crops, and 1.68 crore farmers have registered. Also, 1,000 mundis to be integrated under the said scheme. Deep Ocean Mission to be launched with allocation of 4,000 rupees crore over 4 years. Government announced multi-state cooperative for ease of doing business. Minimum wages now to apply to all categories of workers. Social security benefits will be extended to gig and platform workers too. MSME allocation to be doubled. Government to set aside 15,700 rupees crore in financial year 2022. Income tax return filers increased to 6.48 crores in 2020 from 3.31 crores in 2014. Pensioners over 75 years of age are exempt from filing returns. Affordable housing projects can avail tax holiday for one more year. Government will notify rules to eliminate double tax for NRIs on foreign retirement funds. Government allocates 3,726 rupees crore for forthcoming census. This will be the first digital census. India's fiscal deficit is set to jump to 9.5% of gross domestic product in 2020-21 as per revised estimates. This is sharply higher than 3.5% of GDP that was projected in the budget estimates. A slump in government revenues amid the COVID-19 pandemic has led to a sharp rise in deficit and market borrowing. The total fiscal deficit is funded through government borrowing. An additional 80,000 rupees crore is needed to ensure our economy is given the needed push. The borrowings from the market for next year will be at 12 lakh crores. 69 crore beneficiaries or 86% covered under One Nation, One Ration Scheme. The One Nation, One Ration Card plan has been implemented by 32 states and union territories. Migrant workers benefit from this scheme as they can claim ration from anywhere in the country. Government allots 20,000 rupees crore for bank recapitalization. Government has announced addition of 100 cities to the city gas distribution network. Ujjwala scheme will be extended to cover 1 crore more beneficiaries. Vehicles to undergo fitness tests after 20 YRS for PVS, 15 years for CVS, announcing a voluntary vehicle scrapping policy. Budget announced a push to the textile industry. Government will set up 7 textile parks over 3 years under the scheme of Mega Investment Textile Parks. Customs duty on cotton increased to 10%, silk to 15%, customs duty on some auto parts to be raised to 15%. A new cess on agriculture development, the government has proposed farm cess of 2.5 rupees per liter on petrol, 4 rupees on diesel. A central university in Leh. A focus on seaweed farming with a new facility in Tamil Nadu. Late deposit of employees' contribution to PF by employers will not be allowed as deduction to employer. Proposed to make dividend payments to REIT, estate investment trusts, and InVITs, infrastructure investment trusts, exempt from TDS. To further ease filing of IT returns, details of capital gains and interest from banks, post offices, etc. will be pre-filled. Government to increase maximum threshold paid up capital of small companies from 50 rupees lakh to 2 rupees crore and increase the threshold of maximum turnover from 2 rupees crore to 20 rupees crore. Under this, more than 2 lakh additional companies to come under the definition of small companies which have a lower compliance burden including lower penalties for violations and lower filing requirements. Government proposes to introduce National Nursing and Midwifery Commission Bill. Government proposes National Language Translation Initiative. Mission Poshan 2.0 will be launched to improve nutritional outcomes across 112 aspirational districts. The Economic Survey 2020, presented by Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman on Friday, January 29, 2021, pegged the GDP growth at 11% in financial year 2022. The Economic Survey 2020-21 has projected that India's real GDP growth to be 11% in FY 2021-22 and nominal GDP to be around 15.4%, which is the highest since independence. During the budget presentation in Parliament, the Sensex gained over 1,400 points, Nifty crossed 14,000. At the conclusion of her speech, Sensex was at 47,451.62, up 1,165.85 points.